Hey guys, welcome back to Pro Play Games YouTube page. We're here with Timothy Lay. He is a sponsor player by Pro Play Games, newly formed Pokemon team. So say hi to the camera, TJ. Introduce yourself.
What's up, everybody? TJ from Pro Play Games. Just wanted to profile the deck that I played actually in the feature match that you guys saw. If you guys didn't see that video, make sure you guys check it out. I just wanted to show the deck that I played that day. Just because it has been playing very well. I've been playing it at a couple local LCs and doing pretty well, placing in the top four pretty much every single time. So it's definitely a very consistent deck, definitely a very powerful deck. I'm pretty much gonna just explain the deck as I go through. I've made a lot of changes throughout time, but I'll get into that at the end of the deck. So to start it off, I played four of the Mewtwo EX. I actually played the Shattershot damage change version. Shattershot does 30 times the amount of psychic energy he has attached to him, so it's a decent attack for the one energy, considering you can make it do pretty decent damage later on. Damage change for two psychic and a color, so you can actually put the damage counters that's on the Mewtwo onto your opponent, which is also another very powerful attack that he has. But this is really the big hitter of the deck. This is the Mewtwo EX, the Mega Mewtwo EX. He, for two colorless energies, does 10 damage plus 30 times the amount of energy attached to both active Pokemon. So essentially, if there's six energies on board between the two, three here, three on your opponent's Pokemon, it will do 190 damage.
All right, what are the Pokemon you're running?
I'm also playing the Hoopa. Hoopa to kind of search out resources, including things like this, the Shaymin. Shaymin, which sets up, draws cards for you. I was also playing a 2-2 line of the EV into Espeon GX. I thought that that would be a pretty nice alternative as an attacker that you can set up early in the game. And Divide GX is a decent GX attack. It does allow you to spread some damage, and I've been in situations before where I was able to put damage between two Pokemon and come out with the Mewtwo and get a one-shot on both pretty safely. So it is definitely a very good card. I think it also adds a nice level of consistency to the deck, because starting with that in an energy, you know, being able to side beam to lock your opponent down if they can't attack through the confuse or doesn't want to retreat, you know, whatever the case is, it definitely is a pretty nice starter. For the supporters, I played a pretty standard line, I believe. It's four Sycamore, draw support, you know, it's discard your hand, draw seven, it's very nice. In three of those, I actually like three because this deck, if it bricks, is a very tough deck to play out of because of the fact that you have to Omega Evolve, so having more draw support is definitely nice. I also played two Lysander because it wins games. It pulls out anything you want and you can go for the kill. Skyla to help search out certain item cards and supporter cards and stuff like that definitely came in clutch a lot of the time when I was playing. So did this Professor Kukui. That extra 20 damage that he can add definitely, you know, opens up the deck to not have to dedicate so many energy to a single Mewtwo just to get the one shot. Plus it gets you, you know, two cards plus in your hand, which is not too bad. I also played the one Lily. I think Lily is a pretty strong card. It offers a nice level of consistency as well. In a situation where you don't want your opponent to draw any cards, you know, you don't want to pitch your hand, even if it's just to Lily for three, it has paid off for me at times. So it's definitely not a pushover card. Four-verse Seeker to get supports back pretty much speaks for itself. Support cards are very powerful. Four Ultra Ball just to help grab you stuff from the deck. I mean, this deck can't run without, you know, getting all its Pokemon out and setting up as fast as it can, really. Played three Trainer Mail to help dig out resources like the three Spirit Links you need to evolve the Mega Mewtwo. Definitely necessary. Three Mega Turbo. I did like three Mega Turbo because it allows you to put those energies onto the Mewtwos that you're setting up on the bench in case you do take an unfortunate knockout on your active Mewtwo. It definitely helps you kind of recoup and stand back up as opposed to not having anything to set up. Three Shiner Memories. Like I said, damage change is a very powerful move, and that allows you to use that to, you know, get all the damage that's on your Mewtwos off. One really fun thing to do is Lysandering out your opponent's Shamans, and your Mewtwo has, you know, 120 damage or so on it. Damage change that off, you get the two prizes, and you have a healthy Mewtwo. Also played the 1-1 Special Charge and Super Rod to get back Pokemon in a lot of the times, because a lot of times you will pitch off certain hands because they could be dead, so you will lose them to Sycamore. It's good to kind of recoup those resources, and then Special Charge because Enhanced Hammer's a thing, and you definitely want to be able to use and utilize your double colorless energies as much as possible, so did play the Special Charge as well. Energies is pretty simple. I played eight Psychic Energies and four double colorless. You need energies to do damage. It speaks for itself, the energy line. I mean, I can't really think of cutting it down. I did play seven energy at one point. Seven energy was okay, but you definitely need those energies to Mega Turbo, so that's why I ended up adding another energy in there, and it definitely has paid off. I have made changes over time, like I said, that I've been playing this game, with this deck especially, just because there's things I like and things I don't like at times. I actually have, considering like things you can cut out, I've cut those out before. I actually played Lunala with this deck before. It was a little clunky, so I actually changed out of it, but I've cut these out before. I actually am going to be trying to build with four Mega Mewtwo's and four Spirit Links because sometimes it can be real rough getting the Mega Mewtwo out, and I've actually been considering certain other cards, like Wobbuffet. I think he can kind of catch people by surprise. I think that he would be a good deck choice.
What does Wobbuffet do?
Wobbuffet, he has an ability that basically shuts down any ability that's not a psychic Pokemon, and then he has an attack that does 10 damage plus each damage counter that's on your opponent's Pokemon. So essentially, if their opponent's Pokemon has lost at least half of its health, the Wobbuffet attack will knock it out.
Essentially, on a note, if anyone also doesn't know the rules for the Mega Evolution Pokemon, like the Mega Mewtwo, in evolving the game of Pokemon, if you evolve a regular Pokemon, it can, you know, attack and do its thing. If you do not have a Spirit Link, which is the card that TJ mentioned here, it's a Pokemon tool that attaches to the Mega Mewtwo EX. It allows you to Mega Evolve, and your turn does not end. Because the ruling with the Mega Evolution cards, once you Mega Evolve, your turn will end unless you have the Spirit Link on. So getting the Spirit Link onto that Mega Mewtwo, of course, crucial. TJ, again, has played multiple LCs here in the last month, placing top four and all. I've played against him in the feature match. It was a lot of fun. He's definitely changed the deck. It looks really nice. TJ, anything else to add about the deck or going future? I know he may be trying to attend Virginia coming up in months. Yeah. Is this a possible play for that tournament?
Yeah, definitely. And I think this deck is actually very versatile. I think it can handle a lot of different matchups. Doesn't necessarily have too much of a bad matchup. I guess its worst matchup is something that you know, plays like the Faded Town, which hurts Mega Evolutions, or something that you know, is very heavy on energy disruption, because in that type of situation, even with the three Mega Turbos and the Special Charge and the Super Rod, sometimes it can still be rough in that energy type of fight. So definitely can have some issues with there, but overall I think this deck has a lot of really positive matchups, and it's a very consistent deck, so I think the deck is actually a nice and strong deck. Yeah, there's just a few things that other people can try out. If they see something that they really like, you know, message me about it. Tell me what it is and tell me what you think, because I'm open to suggestions and stuff. This deck is actually a very nice deck, and I think that there's lots of different ways to play this deck. Like I said, I did play Lunala at one point in the deck. I've actually played Lunala with Espeon. I played Lunala with Mega Mewtwo as well. With not playing the Shrine of Memories, I played Silent Lab, and I actually played Max Potions. It worked nice because you're able to shut down abilities on basics with the Silent Labs, and then freely use these guys to attack. If they take damage, you move the energies off, Max Potion, move the energies back on. I mean, it's a very fun deck. But yeah, other than that, I think that, you know, later on this week, we're going to be putting out another feature match. I'm going to be trying a different deck. I don't know about Sean, but I think we're going to, you know, try a nice little feature match later on this week. I'm going to be trying a nice spicy brew with something a little bit different. So make sure you guys keep a lookout on that.
All right, guys. Well, TJ, I appreciate the time and showing us the deck. I've had a lot of fun playing against it. And like TJ said, we're definitely going to be playing different decks entirely. It's going to be part of the weekly feature matches we're going to try and get out, each with a deck profile. We hope that you guys enjoy the content coming out and coming soon. So again, this is Sean from ProPlay Games. Shout out to the shop, TJ, ProPlay Games.
Shout out Machado. Shout out to ProPlay Games.
Shout out Ultra Pro, sponsor, you know, the store and everyone else. We appreciate everyone. So again, guys, coming soon. Stay tuned for new content.